So happy Saturday morning, September 1st. Already, I can't believe it. So we left off yesterday on chapter 4 material. We're still in chapter 4. We will be in chapter 4 for the next at least a couple lecture periods. So we did balancing equations. We did simple stoichiometry, aka Mabey-Trainer problems. We did. We started to do a limiting reactant problem, so we'll take off with that. We'll probably get to molarity today, and then hopefully we'll start precipitation reactants. So we'll see how far we get. Okay, so yesterday we left off on this problem, and I was showing you the Chem 107, probably the way you learned Chem 107. And this is where you first balance a chemical reaction. That's all, how you always start a problem if there's chemistry happening. You take the grams of each reactant, convert them into moles of the product, look at which one is smaller, whichever one is smaller becomes your limiting reactant. You take the moles of the product then from that limiting reactant and you convert those to grams, and that would be your theoretical yield, what in theory you should produce if the reaction was 100% efficient. Now, it also asks another question, you know, how many grams of excess reactant are left over? Or it will also ask you what's the percent yield, and also how many grams of excess reactant are left over. So it doesn't tell you which reactant is the excess when you have to figure that out. Clearly it's oxygen, that's our excess reactant. So what is the percent yield? Well, if we just take the 125 grams of product that it gave us as an actual yield and divide it by the theoretical yield we figured, we calculated, that would be an 88% yield. Right, so that's pretty straightforward, probably not typical. Here's the question that is more difficult to answer. Okay, how much excess reactant's left over? And I think that one's kind of more difficult. Okay, so, excuse me. So how do we figure out how much excess reactant is left over? How do we figure that out? And what it entails really is you first have to figure out how much of your limiting reactant was lost, and then use stoichiometry to relate to how many moles of O2 was lost, and then convert that to grams lost, and then subtract that grams lost from the initial grams that we were given. So just doing that, we know that we had originally 75 grams of aluminum, and that was our limiting reactant. And then we convert that into moles. This is the moles we used. Okay, now to convert those moles into oxygen, stoichiometry can be done not only between reactants and products, it can also be done between reactant to another reactant. So what's my mole ratio from aluminum? O2, what was the mole ratio in that balanced equation?
4 to 3.
Right, it's 4 to 3, right? So for every 4 moles of aluminum, we used up 3 moles of oxygen. And then converting that moles of oxygen to grams, remember O2 has a molar mass of 2 times 16, so 32 grams for every 1 mole of O2. So that would give us a mass of oxygen of 66.71 grams of O2. So what does this grams of O2 represent? Does it represent the mass left over of oxygen, or does it represent the mass that was used up of oxygen? It represents the mass that was used of oxygen. How do we figure out how much mass of oxygen is left? Subtract this from what? The original mass, which was 200 grams, right? So 200 grams of O2 minus the 66.71 that was used. Right,
right now would give us 133.3 grams of O2 that was left. So does this look familiar from Chem 107? Mm-hmm. Probably. And I'd like to do this problem differently using an amounts table. Okay. Are you ready? Brace yourselves. Okay. But I think this will really help you in the long run. Okay. So we're going to do the same problem over again, but now we're going to do it in a way that will, I think, see you through 111B a lot better. Okay, so so for the amounts table method, the first thing we do is, you know, we get the balanced equation, sure, and we convert our starting amounts into moles. All right, so we'll do that. So I'm going to say 75.0 grams of aluminum. So I've got my moles of aluminum, and then I got my moles of oxygen, starting with 200. So initial moles there, okay, and then we have our reaction.